I'm Ben, and this is Susanna.
Hi.
And we're hydroponic gardeners.
Great.
So I guess I can just kind of go through a few of the systems we have.
Okay.
So this one here is a nutrient film type system.
Mm-hmm.
You can see that it's made using a 3-inch PVC pipe.
Mm-hmm.
We drilled all of these holes, and we pump water with a nutrient solution through here,
mm-hmm.
and all these different plants can just grow using that nutrient solution in the sun.
We got catnip, we got lettuces, we got a variety of herbs, parsley, cilantro, and then we have some bok choy that has bloomed because we can't keep up with eating it.
Oh, nice.
So over here, we have potatoes.
Uh-huh.
Now the potatoes are in a perlite based type of hydroponic system.
Mm-hmm.
Again, they use the same nutrient solution, no soil, but of course the potatoes need to grow in something.
Mm-hmm.
So in these barrels here, which have been converted from old barrels used at a laundromat, we got for free.
Uh-huh.
They just grow right in the, and they're looking a little wilty because they got kind of knocked over in the storm yesterday, but they just grow in this perlite here.
So what is perlite? What is that? Is that like an organic?
It's an expanded volcanic rock.
Oh.
So it's lightweight. It's actually added to a lot of soils to help make them fluffy.
So it's entirely, you can reuse it if you know how to do it, if you know how to properly remove the old roots from it.
Okay.
This is partially reused.
Okay.
So now in here we have a squirrel resistant garden.
I'll
say squirrel resistant instead of squirrel proof, you know. And so inside we have several different types of grow systems. These are all tomatoes. Now these were started under grow lights inside, that's why they're so big. We do kind of consider this to be an interesting method to use, but it does work using this netting instead of tomato cages.
Mm-hmm.
Now that's the reservoir for the nutrients, and that gets pumped up through several times a day, and it runs through through this perlite again. So we're using the same stuff,
mm-hmm.
And then back down this pipe and into there. These are, of course, peppers over here.
Mm-hmm.
And then here we have some cucurbits. Now they haven't done so well this year. Part of the reason for that is just the weather.
Mm-hmm.
Usually they do very well in what's called a deep water hydroponic system. So you can see the roots in there.
Oh my gosh, yeah.
And so that is, they just grow in the water with bubbling.
Nice.
Now over here we have soil.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so these were started exactly at the same time as the ones that are in hydroponics. They're growing in soil, mixture of compost and new potting soil.
Mm-hmm.
And they're not growing quite as fast as the hydroponics, but I think I'll still get quite a few tomatoes off of here and the hot peppers in these four.
And these are automatic drippers that just do tap water.
Where's the tap water coming from?
There's a quarter inch
line.
Tubing.
Yeah, okay, so there's a quarter inch tube that goes underground here.
Oh.
And over to here, and then it runs all the way over to the hose bib. So it kind of just goes by the siding here, all the way over to the hose bib.
Uh-huh.
Over there, and that's what supplies water to all of these systems. Actually, the hydroponics for this one, for over there, and those two have automatic fillers, and then these ones here are just automatic or filled by hand, basically.
Mm-hmm.
So from the same line, though.
Beautiful.
So then over here we have a system that's sort of being worked on. The circulation system,
mm-hmm.
but it's a
drip and deep water hybrid. So these buckets are filled to here, and they have aeration from an air stone in the bottom,
mm-hmm.
and there's a pump right here that pumps water to the top and recirculates it. So it's a hybrid of that Dutch bucket and the deep water.
That's fascinating.
Oh yeah, that's the name of the, yeah, sorry,
this,
I didn't say the name of
this. Dutch bucket
this.
System, where it drips in the top and then the excess flows into a tank and is recirculated. So there are nutrients in that tank, and it just goes around.
And recycles.
Mm-hmm. And recycles, yep. So now over here, here's where we have our rain barrels.
Oh, and there's another garden, huh?
Yes, that's our landlord's daughter.
So this system here collects, of course, water from the roof.
Uh-huh.
Actually, we only get to use one half of the side of the roof here. This is our landlord's little garage here, but she lets us use this half for water.
Uh-huh.
And so we have a drip irrigation system here, and I just turn this valve, and water
right
starts
here.
To come out these little drippers.
So that's 2 gallons per hour.
Uh-huh.
From each of those. Now this is a backup system here with the hose that's buried underground and goes and connects on the other side. And that's just in case we don't get enough rain. But this is one circuit here of watering tomatoes, and then a bunch of zucchinis and cucumbers and things, mm-hmm. some peppers that Susanna did over there. Mm-hmm. And then over here is the second circuit of water. All of these rain barrels, there's three of them, they're all connected together with a single line so they balance. Mm-hmm. And well, we've got an overflow barrel, which in last night's storm definitely filled up to the very top.
Wow.
So, mm-hmm. I can also water on this side separately. These plants don't get as much light, so they're on a separate run.
Let me dive in.
Okay.
So over here, we have a couple of extra tomatoes right there, but behind it, we took out all the honeysuckles and weeds that were there, prepared the soil, and put in wildflowers. They're just coming up. They're only about this tall right now. Mm-hmm. So we're going to have a lot of marigolds and a wildflower native species mix that got sowed in there. It's just a few of the extra tomatoes we didn't have room for on the other side.
Uh-huh. Then, what kind of tree is this?
So it's got plums, but the squirrels I think might have already gotten all of them. Oh, there's a pear tree and a plum tree, but I don't see any fruit left on this
one. I see a little bit, but there's
There's one.
It bloomed beautifully, but the squirrels just get all the fruits. That's why we had a squirrel-proof, our main garden, main hydroponic garden. This is where I put all the plants that I'm too sorry to kill when they have to go out of the hydroponic system when they start blooming. Uh-huh. I'm going to collect the seed from some of them. We planted some shade species that we were gifted on last year's backyard tour.
Oh, okay.
So they actually came up. Solomon's something.
Solomon's.
Yep.
Seal.
Okay.
Uh-huh.
And then we have compost. We're not really trying to generate a lot of compost for use in the garden because we're renting, we'll have to move. But it lets us put our kitchen scraps and garden scraps in here rather than into our curbside bin.
Sure.
So put them in here first, then the second one, and then this is all last year's compost. It's almost finished. I put a couple peas in there, but I think the cutworms got them. So this should be ready to put into flower pots next spring.
Fantastic.
And then we have our house plants over under the window. We have to keep them in the shade because otherwise they just get too much sunburn.
Yeah.
But I think that when people visit, if they would like to take cuttings or little baby plants to take home, we've got plenty to give away.
Oh, lovely.
And then there's a container garden. We thought this would be our fall garden because we thought we could put a painter's plastic from the house and kind of prevent a little bit of frost. But it turns out they only get morning sun here. Mm-hmm. It's not quite enough for tomatoes. But
those are strawberries?
The strawberries. Yeah. The strawberries seem to like it, and I also have a bunch of herbs. Anything that kind of overflow from the hydroponic system gets stuck in here. Again, I have a cutworm problem with all of the soil systems, and I don't want to use pesticides, so mm-hmm. it's coming out here with a flashlight at night to pick them off. Mm-hmm. But just herbs and strawberries for now.
That's lovely. I mean, it's a great garden.
Oh, and then in the front yard, we have more house plants, and they're also on an automatic watering system.
How long have you been doing this?
So we moved here about 2 years ago. Before that, it was all in apartments and on porches. This system is the exact same size as this porch at his old apartment, and we moved in here with plants mid-season 2 years ago. That was quite an adventure. The plants suffered a terrible storm the very first night we moved, mm-hmm. but we still got a lot of tomatoes that year. We've been canning, and last year we tried canning green tomatoes too, which tastes a lot like pickles.
That is wonderful.